Hello, this is Scott and this is a Hype Report. Today's report is sponsored by the free book Ramblings of a Madman. Here are the quotes for various items. First, wake-up call. According to Egon Van Graes, 2014 will be the year when people get the most unexpected and shocking wake-up call. World markets like the stock markets and property markets are all finishing a major secular bull market. He goes on to say that the collapse in the world markets and economy will probably start with the most currencies falling sharply. Next, Dubai. Dubai became the largest transit city for physical gold in the world last year, with around 40% or 2,250 tons passing through the city. Gold worth a total of $75 billion was moved through Dubai in 2013, and it is a pretty safe bet that it was not heading to the Fed. Next, where's the workers? The U.S. unemployment rate is down, but a rising number of Americans have dropped out of the labor force entirely. Even though the official unemployment rate is lower at 6.7%, a record low of 63.2% of Americans 16 and older are participating in the labor force. Maybe they are all on disability? Next, Obama's NSA deception. As part of his so-called NSA reforms, Obama has ordered the NSA not to collect 30% of Americans' phone records and communications, but 100%. Makes one wonder why the Supreme Court has declined an early look into the NSA surveillance case on the constitutionality of the NSA's mass recording of phone calls. Guess the court did not want to be in the forefront of another election. Next, IRS testimony. Obama and others have stated that the IRS did no targeting. However, IRS agents under oath testified that only new groups opposing Obama were targeted. Gee, yet another lie. You could have knocked me over with a wet noodle with that one. Next, gun control fail. Less than 5,000 New Yorkers have registered their assault weapons as per the state's SAFE Act. This means that 99% of New Yorkers will likely miss the April 15th deadline. Perhaps they are willing to lie, defy, and not comply with any unconstitutional law. If civil disobedience worked for Gandhi and Nelson Mandela, it should work against the tyrants in New York State. Next, fuel from seawater. Although working on improving the efficiency, the U.S. Navy, working with several universities, demonstrated that extracting hydrogen and carbon dioxide from seawater can produce fuel for ships and planes. Finally, please prepare now for the escalating economic and social unrest. Good day.